this video because October 2015 is outstanding for Taurus people. So for one thing, October 15 may be the best month of 2015 anyway, but I'm kind of starting with the new moon. And my advice to everybody is maximize your luck as it comes along and continue with upgrades, because we live in a world of upgrades, right? So that's not going to end. Now, just to kind of divide the month into half, starting off with the first half of the month, you see that's all in red. Those are all challenging aspects. And then when we get into the mid part, particularly after the 10th of October, that's when things start getting better. So I'm going to explain these. For one thing, if you've heard about Mercury retrograde, well, 1 out of 4 people are born with Mercury retrograde. But if you weren't, then that time period is confusing. Everyone gets into research mode, they're troubleshooting. In your case, you probably had a lot of things, because it was in your 6th house, so it had a lot to do with duties and health and your job and accounting. So this is particularly challenging, but maybe useful for you in the long run. And so we're starting the month with that planet retrograde. October 3rd through 9th, we have another kind of bizarre situation when Mars forms opposition to Neptune. Now, this is not a typically good mix in the sense that Mars is intense and headstrong and Neptune is sensitive. So this could be a couple they don't get along. In your case, it might be your children or your own talent needs some integration into a group situation, and you're trying to figure out how can you fit in so you don't, bring your children into a situation and not upset people. So just keep in mind that during this time, everyone's going to be really, really sensitive. Now, a square is a little different from an opposition. Opposition is balance, but a square is definitely challenge and tension. And we have a square, October 4th through 9th, Sun is square to Pluto. So the Sun represents what's happening now. It's the energy, so your focus on job, your duties, and your health. But what's your reservoir of power, if you will, is in your 9th house. So either you have a really powerful education, or you have this developing religious sense or a global awareness that is really means a lot to you. So here you're trying to fit these two together, where you have this job, but then you have this higher aspiration possibly. So this conflict is begging to be resolved, let's say. October 6th through 10th, we have Jupiter trine Pluto. It might be longer, it might be through the 16th or the 18th, actually. And so this is a great combination. In fact, this is what I'm really excited about regarding October for everyone. And in this case, you have this great sense of your own talent, and you are able to analyze the knack for probability. And the thing is then how, now you have a sense of how this can work well with your educational background in a religious context or in a global sense. October 9th, Mercury goes back to prograde motion, so at this point your work will be easier, and your counting will be easier. And then we're getting up into the new moon. The actual new moon is October 12th, and the Sun is conjunct Spica, and Spica is the shaft of grain being held by the agricultural goddess. New moon is always a tabula rasa. That means it's clear and open. There's this sense of expectation. There could be prophetic things. It can be hopeful. It can also be introverted, so you want to get out there and do things connected to your work and your job. Now, the areas in play here are science, agriculture, and philosophy. And some of the scenes that are active are culture, music, and art. And the issue may be hope versus cynicism. So let's push towards the hope side in connection with your duty, your job, and your health. And so there's this whole thing to be attuned to culture, science, and justice. These provide an interesting good life for you. Now, Uranus is bringing some surprises through your 12th house, and that means you may have vivid dreams. You may be somewhat prophetic. You might have to deal with things like a nemesis, someone or something that is driving you crazy. Now, this Uranus could be world events. It could be some new invention, or could it be something that you're not even aware of. There's a lot of new technology out there that is afflicting people's health, and they're not even aware of it now, like microwaves or whatever. So you might want to do some research on that. And they sometimes are mirrored through your dreams. October 14th through 20th, Mars is conjunct Jupiter. So again, we're reactivating your fifth house. So your talent, you're getting more confident with your talent. Your children may be developing nicely. If you have any children, you have a great knack for probability. And there's no better time to really develop your talent, you know, maybe to invest more in it, to get some lessons. And this is forming a trine relationship to the powers that be, and that there may be some great wealth potential in this. And then October 24th through 26th, that Venus now is conjunct. So these are the two bright lights are uniting to bring joy and celebration. Again, more talent, children, luck. Very positive area. Now, this is the thing that I think is going to be really great for you is this full moon. And that's October 25th through 29th. So when you have a full moon in your first house, this means you really kind of light up. I mean, you're even though it's your half birthday, beginning of your half birthday, which is always a time where you depend a lot on other people, that you will feel illuminated by this full moon. And so it's a great time for you to get out there and get, you know, the full moon is drama, partnerships, rich social life, many events. So you're going to participate and, you know, spread yourself around, you know, get out there. And first house is also conjunct the Andromeda Galaxy, which when it was discovered, this is, you know, expanded our idea of the universe. So you can think outside the box. You can be a leader in outside the box thinking. It's also near the triangle, so you could be an advocate for justice-oriented, truthful, and righteous, benevolent types of activities. I mean, that's pretty cool. Also, you may be more sensitive to what's happening. It's in the heart of the whale, so you can feel the pulse of life. These are all constellations where the moon is activating. And then the head of the ram is also strong primal instincts. So that's also being activated on the full moon. Overall, it's forming a grand trine in the heavens, and this can see huge conglomerates. You could join with people. You could make some really good contacts, and this could be just a very positive time for you. And make use of this, because when November rolls around, we're all going to have to be seeing some signs of stoicism and sacrifice and toughening up. So max your luck in October is all I can say, because November is going to be a whole different story. Anyway, thank you very much for watching, and I hope it works out for you. My name is Victoria Martin.